children, you have to listen to Angelina. She's going to summarize the story of David okay. Copperfield for you.
Okay.
Okay. Angelina?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Summarize it so that others will get a clear idea. Then we will move on to the next.
There once lived a boy named David Copperfield.
Yes.
When he was very young, his mother died.
Yes.
So his stepfather sent him to work in an unsuitable place.
Very good.
He found it very difficult, and he ran to his aunt aunt's house.
Yes.
And the aunt was not yes. able to recognize the boy.
Yes. What was the name of aunt?
The name of the aunt is Betsy.
Wait, wait, Ahil, please, please. Angelina is summarizing the story. Please listen to her. She's doing it very well. Very good, Angelina. What is the name of her, his aunt, the boy's aunt?
Miss Betsy.
Yes, Miss Betsy. Continue.
And she said, "Go along, no boy's here." Mm. She shook her head. She marched to the corner of the garden and stooped to dig up some more.
Yes.
David Copperfield.
Excuse me, ma'am.
But with a great deal of desperation and violence.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Angelina, one second.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Trinova.
Ma'am, I can't hear you because of the internet connection problem.
Okay, Angelina is summarizing the story. Please try to listen to her. Check your audibility, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Angelina, continue.
Okay, ma'am.
I went.
Please make it louder. Okay.
But
say it louder.
But with a great deal of desperation, I yes. went and stood beside her. Mm. "If you please, ma'am," mm. he said. Mm. She looked up and she stopped and looked up. Mm. "If you please, aunt," exclaimed Miss Betsy in a tone of amazement that I have never heard before.
Okay, Angelina, the first part of the story was very interesting. Now you are reading the text. Now I feel that you are reading the text. Can you just summarize it? What did Miss Betsy do after recognizing David as her nephew?
She sat on the gravel.
What did Aunt Betsy do after recognizing the boy as her nephew? Did she tell him to go away again?
No. She got up and hurried and took him to the parlor.
Yes. She took him to the parlor. Yes. Anandan, you can continue. Thank you, Angelina. Anandan will continue.
Somewhere, ma'am.
Yes. She took the boy to parlor. Then what happened?
Unable to control my soul.
No. Don't read out from the text. Your friends are listening to you. They want to know the story. What happened in the story? After Aunt Betsy taking the boy to the parlor, what did she do?
She.
No, I'm going to.
Tell me the story.
We should read a story.
No. I don't want you to read it from the text. Children will do by themselves. They know to read.
Okay.
That's what they told. Okay. So we find that after taking the boy to the parlor, Aunt Betsy treats him very well. She treated him. How did she treat him? She took a shawl and she kept it behind his head and a handkerchief and she kept it under his feet. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So, the lady, Aunt Betsy, placed David on the sofa with a shawl under his head and a handkerchief
feet
under his feet so that the sofa cover will not be dirty. After that, she calls Janet. Do you know who is Janet?
Yes, the servant.
Yes, the servant of Miss Betsy. Janet is the servant of Miss Betsy. She calls Janet and asks Janet to inform Mr. Dick.
Mr.
Dick to come downstairs. Okay, Mr. Dick is staying in the upstairs, and she tells Janet to go and call Mr. Dick downstairs. Is that clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and after that we find a man, a gentleman, comes down the staircase. Do you know who is Mr. Dick?
Mr. Dick.
One at a time. If you know the answer, just raise your hand. That's it. No more shouting loudly.
Ma'am.
Yes, Sri Shankar.
I'm a relative of Miss Betsy.
Yes, Mr. Dick is a distant relative of Miss Betsy, and he is a close friend.
Close
friend and a distant relative. Close friend and a distant relative of Miss Betsy. So Mr. Dick comes down to meet the boy. Okay, and after seeing the boy, he was wondering who is this person. He gives a look at the boy, and Aunt Betsy tells him, "Don't tell me an excuse. Don't give me an excuse that you have forgotten the name that I mentioned to you earlier, David Copperfield." So we find that Miss Betsy has already told Mr. Dick about David Copperfield. Do you know who is David Copperfield here? It's not about the boy, but
David Copperfield's father.
Yes, David's father. David's father is said to be David Copperfield, and the boy is referred as young David Copperfield.
David Copperfield.
Did you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
So in the story, David's father is referred as David Copperfield, and the boy is referred as young David Copperfield. Yes. So Miss Aunt Betsy, Miss Betsy tells Mr. Dick, "Don't tell me, don't give me an excuse, don't act foolishly. I have told you about David Copperfield before. Don't you remember him?" So Mr. Dick thinks for a while, and then he tells Aunt, Yes. I think I remember. I think I have heard this name before." And he gives a look at the boy. And Miss Betsy tells him, "This is his son of David Copperfield. This is the young David Copperfield in front of you." And the next question that she asked Mr. Dick is, "What am I supposed to do with the boy?" So she was so surprised to see her nephew. Okay, she was so surprised to see her nephew, and she's so confused what to do with the boy. And towards the end of the story, we find that Mr. Dick gives a solution. If I were instead of you, definitely I would give him a good bath. Yes, I would give him a good bath. I would heat the water for giving him a bath, because we find that the boy was dirty. Nobody was there to look after him, and he ran away from that unsuitable place from his stepfather. So we find that the boy gets help from his aunt. His aunt treats him very well, and she accepts him into her house. That is all about the story about David Copperfield. Okay, a small portion from the big novel, David Copperfield. So children, when you come back to school, if you get a chance, definitely you have to go to the library and you have to get the book David Copperfield, an abridged version, which means the novel which is written in a simple form for children, that you have to pick up and you have to read. Did you all agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Already we can buy this.
Yes, of course, if you want you can buy.
Ma'am, one at a time.
Just raise your hand. Let me see.
Ma'am.
Pranav?
Ma'am, doubt here.
Okay, what is the doubt?
Ma'am, in our library, the David Copperfield book will be there.
Yes, yes. David Copperfield's book is there.
If it is not there, we can buy.
It is there. Of course it is there. Okay, I have seen it. So many books by Charles Dickens is there. David Copperfield, Great Expectation, Oliver Twist. So many books are there. Okay. So definitely when you come back to school, you can go to the library, pick up one and enjoy reading it. You have to read the abridged version. Okay. It's written in a simple form, because original version is a bit tough for you to understand.
Yes, ma'am. Big words.
Yes. The original book is a bit tough for you to understand. So you have to take the simple form and read.
Yes.
So children, did you understand the story?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So I have uploaded the notes of the chapter David Copperfield in our website.
Okay,
you have to copy down neatly onto the ruled sheets. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Ruled. Okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
So
I had downloaded.
You have to read to the textbook, and then if you have any doubts, you can contact me. All right.
Okay, PDF. Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
So, shall we move to another chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. So, can you please keep it in muted mode?
Yes, ma'am.
Shreya is always singing. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Ma'am, here I'm saying slowly, but there my internet connection is lagging.
It is more lagging. Okay, don't sing. Okay, when you say, you say it very firmly. Okay. All right, children.
Next lesson is Happy Prince.
Yes. The next chapter that we are going to deal with
Happy Prince.
Happy Prince.
I read
the Happy Prince.
Written
by?
No activities. No activities.
By who? Oscar Wilde.
Oscar Wilde.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, my dear.
Some disturbance.
Ma'am, I have said it, Happy Prince, in other school.
Children, please unmute everyone. Please unmute. I know that you are very active and you wanted to tell me so many things.
Ma'am, mute.
Sorry, mute. Everyone, please mute. Okay, by mistake I said. Everyone, please mute. You may have a lot of things to share with me. Definitely, when you come back to the school, I will come to meet you, okay? At that time, you will be having another teacher, I guess.
Bye.
Okay. But then definitely, I'll come to meet you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay?
You should.
So, now for the time being, please keep in muted mode. We are moving to another chapter, The Happy Prince, written by Oscar Wilde. Okay? I'm going to share the screen for you.
I know Happy Prince story. I see in YouTube.
Yes?
Ma'am.
I see in YouTube Happy
Prince. Happy Prince in.
Okay. You may be able to see the video of Happy Prince in YouTube.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see the children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Who is this person?
No, ma'am.
Everyone is making a lot of noise. I don't want that to happen.
Old photo. Ma'am, this is old photo.
Who is this person? Any guess?
Ma'am.
Oscar Wilde.
Yes, Oscar Wilde. Okay, so take down the details about Oscar Wilde. How many of you are familiar with the writer Oscar Wilde? How many are familiar with? Have you read any stories by Oscar Wilde?
Yes, Happy Prince.
No, ma'am.
No, you haven't read. Okay. So I'm going to give you the details about Oscar Wilde. Write it down.
Ma'am, should I write?
Yes, you can note down the important points.
Okay, ma'am.
Oscar Wilde. The name of the author of the short story Happy Prince is Oscar Wilde.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Oscar Wilde was born on 16th October
1854. Okay, ma'am.
16
October
1854. Can we
write? Yes. Please keep in muted mode and write. Okay, take down as many points as you can. I'm just giving you some details about the author. He was born on 16th October 1854 in Dublin, in Ireland. So the nationality of the writer is?
Ma'am, where are we to write?
Write it in a rough book. The writer, Oscar Wilde, is an Irish writer. The birthplace is Ireland. Okay. He is an Irish writer. Okay. And the full name. Do you want to know the full name of Oscar Wilde?
Yes, ma'am.
The name is very big.
It's all right.
Not just like our names. The name. This name is very big.
No problem.
Oscar.
No problem.
Finger. of Lahati? Of Lahati, Wills Wild. See how big the name is?
Oh my God.
Oscar Fingal of Lahati, Wills Wild. So such a big name. The author has got such a big name. Yes.
I cannot.
Why these little ones are chattering in between?
Oscar,
are you not listening to me?
Oscar Fingal and?
Oscar Fingal of Lahati Wills Wild. That is his full name. Okay. And maybe for the reader's convenience, it has shortened to Oscar Wilde. The first name and the last name has been taken and it has been put together. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. So children, the writer Oscar Wilde belongs to which nation?
Ireland.
Is he a Russian writer?
Ireland.
Is he a American writer?
No, ma'am.
Is he an Indian writer?
Irish writer.
And what is that?
Irish writer.
Oscar Wilde is an Irish writer. He was born in Dublin in Ireland. What is the full name of Oscar Wilde?
Oscar Fingal.
Oscar Fingal of Lahati, Wills Wilde. Okay. So during that time,
Oscar Fingal.
Such long names were so fashionable. Okay. Long names were so fashionable. So Oscar's parents thought that let us give him such a name. All right. You got it?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's have a look at some more details about Oscar Wilde. Occupation of the author. Yes. Who can tell me what were the occupation of the author?
Writer.
Writer. Very good. Very good. He was a
writer.
Playwright. Playwright means a person who writes drama or plays. Right? Then short stories. Short story writer.
Short film.
Yes. Short story writer, playwright, short story writer, and poet. Okay. So he has carried out various occupations in his life. That is, he was a playwright, he was a short story writer, and a poet. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So, shall we look at some of the other images?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Children, okay, just a minute. The entire thing has disappeared. Please wait for a second. Let it get loaded. Angelina Rose belongs to our class, children. Yes, Angelina?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
Yes, ma'am.
What about Manu?
Manu
belongs to 5th standard or 6th, I don't know. Okay, so this is another image of Oscar Wilde. And okay, so I'm showing you different images of Oscar Wilde.
Ma'am.
Yes?
Excuse me, ma'am. There's only one picture here.
Ma'am, only. Ma'am, can't see.
We can't see.
Children, can you see this image?
Yes, ma'am.
This is the page of some of the short stories written for children by Oscar Wilde. Okay, Oscar Wilde stories for children.
We will find it in the library.
This is another cover page. Okay, Oscar Wilde stories.
I can't see.
Basically, he wrote for children. Somebody is speaking in between. What is the disturbance happening there? I have told you to keep in muted mode, but many are not doing that. Okay, another cover page. Fairy Tales of Oscar Wilde.
That also.
Yes. Happy Prince and Other Tales, Oscar Wilde. By Oscar Wilde. Okay, so this particular book was mainly written for children. So we find that Oscar Wilde writes for children. Okay, Oscar Wilde has written stories for children and plays for adults. Who is creating the sound here?
Like something is vibrating.
Oscar Wilde has written short stories mainly for children, and the story which we are going to learn is
Happy Prince.
The Happy Prince. That is the image that I showed you here. Okay, The Happy Prince and Other Tales. In this particular book, mainly five stories are there. Five short story. Okay. Five short stories. The Happy Prince is one among them.
We should write this.
If you want, you can note down.
Okay.
And it was published in May 18. Yes, it was published in May 1988. Sorry, 1888. It was published in the year May 1888.
Ma'am, published means what?
Published means the book was published. The book was brought into light. After writing the stories, it should be published by a publisher. Okay, it should be printed and has to be published. Then only the people, the readers will be able to read it. Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Siyana, do you belong to this class?
Yes, ma'am. Siyana is in our class.
Okay. So dear children, I hope you have got enough details about the author, Oscar Wilde. Okay, read it and be ready for the next class. In the next class, we will start with the chapter. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Shall we wind up?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, children. I'll meet you in the next class. Okay, bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.